Tirol. I'm one of the heirs of our great grandfather, Sir Jaco, Senyerist Tirol Senior, and our grandmother, Doña Trinidad Ontiveros. And my father is Leon Ontiveros Tirol, one of the 10 children of our grandparents. We were lucky to inherit what was given to us by our great grandfather. The Tirols own most of the northern part of the island. Our grandfather owned mostly the lowlands. My memories were when I was like 8, because he would really come and enjoy the island. That time, no roads. When we are close to the shore already, we would look down. That's about, I would think, about 12 feet or 15 feet. We think it's only like about 4 feet, 5 feet. We would dive only to find out it's that deep. That's how clear the waters were. Very, very clear. You could hardly see the background close to the vegetation area because the sun was so white. It was so glaring. It was blinding. That was how white the sand of Boracay was. When we play in the beach, we would wet our faces, dip our faces in the sand, go up, and then we would have all white hair. We get this algae, we put it on our head, so we would look like zombies. Or, you know, those guys in the Amazon. It was coconut trees, mostly coconut trees. In the inland, there were a few rice fields, and then some watersheds, go fishing. Up to the last, our family was one of those that really tried to preserve the island. But you cannot fight progress. You cannot fight people coming in, developers. So we had to go with the tide. Because of these developments in the island, a lot of us here who has lived in the city, we knew something was gonna blow up in our faces one day. And a lot of investors, they would just come in here, they would invest, make, but their goal is to really make money.
But now that you've seen the effect of the closure, what do you think? Was it good?
It was good. It was long overdue, you know. Los Indios, who was on the Bulabog side, they were hit with the road widening. Almost one half of the restaurant, which was the, I would say, number one or two, you know, in the island. A lot of Europeans would go there. I guess the owners got frustrated. They wanted to move out. They wanted to go back to Manila. It so happened, my son, they know the owners, they talk to them. Then my wife, they bought Los Indios. Everything, you know. The name, you know, the waiters, the tables, the chairs, everything. The utensils, everything. And when it was gone, you know, while we were repairing this, people were already looking for it. And then when we opened, we didn't have any problem. This is good. I have 5 beautiful grandchildren. For one, you know, I want them to know their roots. So wherever they go, they always come back and try to look after the environment.